Welcome to the 20th annual Mystery BHS competition. My name is Alexa Lasley.
And I am Jillian Oliver.
And we will be your 2024 Mystery BHS hosts. I was an escort in 2018 and...
And I was an escort last year.
So we have been in Mystery BHS before, and we hope you are ready for a fantastic night of talents, athletics, and dancing. And without further ado, put your hands together for the Mystery BHS contestants of 2024.
My name is Nicky Percy, I'm contestant number one, and tonight I'm going to shine brighter than the sun.
Aiden Flaherty, contestant number two, and I'm way better than the rest of this crew.
Kaden Keane, contestant number three, none of these guys compare to me.
Andre Sound, contestant number four, when you see me, you'll want some more.
My name is Gavin McLeod, contestant number five, and I'm going to make you feel alive.
My name is Brennan Shrek, contestant number six, hide your aunties and your chicks.
My name is Colin DeShamo, contestant number seven. On a scale of 1 to 10, I'm an 11.
My name is Connor Cole, contestant number eight, and winning this competition is my fate.
My name is Rio Dorado, contestant number nine, and I think you're so fine.
I'm Jaden Lovell, contestant number 10, and you're going to see me on ESPN.
My name is Aiden Toohey, contestant number 11, and my act is going to send you to heaven.
My name is Tim Heath, contestant number 1-2, and I can't wait to show you what I can do.
My name's Sean Thomas, contestant number 13. When the crowd hears me, they're going to scream.
Chris Ullman, contestant number 1-4. After this, you'll want some more.
Wow, those guys have some moves. I wish I could dance like that. I wonder if our ladies have moves like that, too. I guess we'll have to see. Now introducing the escort dance.
Thank you.
on to the next portion of the evening, the athletic portion, and let's see who is the true king of the jungle. Moving on, that was amazing. So now this wouldn't be a competition without judges, so let me introduce them to you. Our first judge is Mr. Murphy. Mr. Murphy is a guidance counselor here at East Bridgewater. There he is, yep. And he co-advises the comedy club. Fun fact about him is that he piloted a plane. Up next, we have judge number two, Ms. Moniz. She is a health and phys ed teacher here at the high school and went to Bridgewater State. Fun fact about her is that she is the girls' varsity lacrosse coach. And last but not least, judge number three is Mr. O'Sullivan. He is also a teacher here at East Bridgewater High School and is also an EBHS graduate. Fun fact about him is that he used to have a blonde man bun. Thank you, judges, for your time tonight, and you have a tough job on your hands, so I wish you luck. So without further ado, we're going to move on to the talent portion of the evening. Up first, we definitely have our most patriotic contestant, so please remove your caps and hats for contestant number four, Jace Allen.
My children and my wife, thank my lucky stars, be here today. Cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I'd gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. Across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA. Well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American. Well, at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. And I'm proud to be an American. Well, at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
That was so patriotic, I absolutely love it. Yes, another round of applause for Jace. Woo! Now, I bet you won't be able to take next talent. Contestant number one, Nick Kaposi.
Just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived. And thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Pardon the way that I stare. There's nothing else to compare. The sight of you leaves me weak. There are no words left to speak. Please let me know that it's real. I feel. Let me know that it's real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Trust in me when I say, oh pretty baby, don't bring me down, I swear. Oh pretty baby, now that I've found you, stay and let me love you, baby. Let me love you. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Classic, great singing voice. Our next contestant is giving Jace a run for his money for most patriotic, so we'll leave that up to you guys, who you think won that one. Let's give it up for contestant number 6, Brendan Shea.
American girls, American guys will always stand up and salute, will always recognize when we see old glory flying. There's a lot of men dead, so we can sleep in peace at night when we lay down our heads. Daddy served in the army, he lost his right eye, but he flew a flag out in our yard till the day that he died. He wanted my mother, my brother, my sister and me to grow up and live happy in the land of the free. Now this nation that I love is falling under attack. A mighty sucker punch came flying in from somewhere in the back. Soon as we could see it clearly through our big black eye, man, we lit up your world like the 4th of July. Hey, Uncle Sam, put your name at the top of his list. Statue of Liberty started shaking her fist, and the eagle will fly, and there's gonna be hell when you hear Mother Freedom start a ringing her bell, and it'll feel like the whole wide world is raining down on you. All brought to you courtesy of my red, white, and blue. Yes. Long justice will be served and the battle will rage. This big dog will bite when you rattle his cage. You'll be sorry that you mess with the U.S. of A. We'll put a boot in your ass, it's the American way. Hey, Uncle Sam, put your name at the top of his list. The Statue of Liberty started shaking her fist, and the eagle will fly, and there's gonna be hell when you hear Mother Freedom start ringing her bell, and it'll feel like the whole wide world is raining down on you. All brought to you courtesy of my red, white, and blue. Oh, oh my red, white, and blue. Oh, 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 oh my red, white, and blue.
Truly made for his voice. Like, it fits perfectly. In addition to all of our wonderful contestants, they have many other students and other performers helping them. So we just wanted to shout out and acknowledge all of those other performers. So we have Ethan Pohl, Ethan Sareva, Colin Brown, Owen Fay, Nick Jordan, Connor Egan, Matt Wera, Robbie Mavilia, Sean Gurney, Brody Lovell, Pat Spillane, and Andrew Carlson. A little fun fact is we're actually the first female hosts in all 20 years of Mystery VHS, so.
None of the guys can make it tonight, so we were more than gladly to come.
Happily filled in. Up next, we have contestant number 7, Colin DeChambeau.
Hello? Bring me down. Oh, I'll never know what makes this man with all the love that his heart can't stand and dream of ways to throw it all away. Thank you.
truly such a talent that I could never have.
I did take guitar lessons for probably like 2 months. Nowhere close to that. That is absolutely fantastic, Colin. Yes, another round of applause, because that is tough. And he made it look so easy. That's the thing. Just drum and guitar.
To spice it up a little bit, we're going to do some trivia about the contestants in the show. So our first question for the night, if anybody knows, just shout it out. Which contestant owns a lawn care business? Yes, it is Chris Omen. I feel like that's kind of an easy one. It'll get harder, though. Without further ado, we have the tall and talented contestant number two, Aiden Flaherty.
Can my lovely assistant, Jason Allen, come on the stage, please? Jason Allen is the most magical person I know, but it has nothing to do with this trick. Can you please mix that up, Jace? Thank you. A completely mixed up Rubik's Cube. I'm going to hold behind my back, and when I count it, or you guys will count to three, and by count three, it'll be solved. Ready? One, two, three. Never take your eyes off the prize. For my last one, I will solve it in the bag. Can I get a drum roll from Jace and the crowd? Thank you, Miss Bridgewater.
Thank you, Aiden. I have never actually completed one of those, so that is fantastic. Behind the back is kind of crazy, and in a bag is also crazy, but the next act is one you will carelessly whisper about. Contestant number three, Caden Keeb.
As I take your hand and lead you to the dance floor. As the music dies, something in your eyes calls to mind a silver screen and all its sad goodbyes. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm, though it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. Should've known better than to cheat a friend. Waste a chance that I had been given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I danced with you. Whispers are to the heart or mind. Ignorance is kind. There's no comfort in the truth. Pain is all you'll find. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend, I know you're not a fool. Should have known better than to cheat a friend. Waste a chance that I had been given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I dance with you. Music seems so loud. I wish that we could lose this crowd. Baby, it's better this way. We hurt each other with the things we wanna say. We could have been so good together. We could have lived this dance forever. But now, who's gonna dance with me? Please stay. And I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend, I know you're not a fool. Should have known better than to cheat a friend. Waste a chance that I had been given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I danced with you.
Awesome job, Kaden. We're gonna hit you with some more trivia. What contestant can wiggle his ears? Rio. Not Rio.
Someone said it.
Not Colin.
Wait, someone said
not Aiden.
Someone said it.
Oh. Tim? Tim? Yes, Tim is the right answer. Moving along. You're really the trigger, contestant number 8, Connor Cole.
Give me your attention, baby. I gotta tell you a little something about yourself. You're a wonderful, flawless, ooh, you sexy lady. But you walk around here like you wanna be someone else. Whoa, I know that you don't know it, but you're fine, so fine, fine, so fine. Ooh, whoa, ooh, girl, I'm gonna show you when you're mine, oh mine, mine, oh mine. Treasure, that is what you are. Honey, you're my golden star. You know you can make my wish come true. If you let me treasure you. If you let me treasure. Oh, oh, oh. Pretty girl, pretty girl, pretty girl, you should be smiling. A girl like you should never look so blue. You're everything I see in my dreams. I wouldn't say that to you if it wasn't true. Ooh, whoa, I know that you don't know it, but you're fine, so fine, fine, so fine. Ooh, whoa, ooh, girl, I'm gonna show you when you're mine, oh mine, mine, oh mine. Treasure, that is what you are. Honey, you're my golden star. You know you can make my wish come true. If you let me treasure you. If you let me treasure. Oh, oh, oh. You are my treasure.
you are my treasure. You are my treasure. Yeah, you are my treasure. You are my treasure. You are my treasure. Yeah, you are treasure. That is what you are. Honey, you're my golden star. You know you can make my wish come true if you let me treasure you. If you let me treasure, oh, oh, oh. Let's go!
What a great way to end Act One. So now we're gonna have a short 15-ish minute intermission, and make sure you support the Seventh and Eighth Grade Student Council. They are selling concessions at the concession stand in the lobby.
Welcome back. I hope everyone enjoyed that concession stand. We just want to give a brief heads up. When the judges are deliberating at the end of the show, there's going to be a QR code to pick your fan favorite. So be thinking of what act you want to win that category, because
that's up to you.
That is the audience's pick.
The judges have no say in what happens in that one, so it's truly all up to you. If one person votes, then it's just your say.
To start off the second act, we are going to start with contestant number 13, Sean Thomas.
To see if I still here with you, girl, I think it just couldn't be the same. I'm as free as a bird now, and this bed you cannot change.
Thank you. have a little Sean Thomas fan club over here. I love the energy, love it. A fun fact about that act, actually, the bass player who was supposed to play in Sean's little group got the flu, so that bass player came in today. They got him this morning. It's one of Sean's friends from Stoughton, so round of applause for this group. We're going to do one more trivia question.
Oh, no.
Which one of the...
So, what was the question?
Escorts could do a headstand on a paddleboard. Someone's sitting in the front. It's Rachel Winker, which is super cool.
Abs.
It's hard standing on one of those. A headstand must be like 10 times harder. But up next, we have contestant number 5, Kevin McLeod. And I think he's going to give Elvis a little run for his money on King of the Jungle. Escort Lilia Fagundes. And if you want to see more of Lilia Fagundes and a couple other students that go to EB, drama program is putting on Mamma Mia next week, Thursday and Friday. Thursday's a 7 o'clock show, Friday's a 5 o'clock show.
We both were in those.
We were both in the drama productions when we were here, and it is a 10 out of 10 show, so you should totally come and see it. Who doesn't love Mamma Mia? No one. Everyone does.
Great music. Let's kick it with our next contestant, contestant number 9, Rio Donato.
Cincinnati. Hats in the sky, rapping five till I die. Red laces in the night, then Air Max 95s. I walk on the moon, flow hotter than Joe. One album from Young Money, then here come the stand through. Peace to my man Joe for giving us spare room. Now we hit the switch till spring break, can't cool. Get it, now forget it, so whoop, I live it. Made the letter B more famous than the Red Sox fitted. But that was suicide. All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough, no. And every time I step up in the building, everybody hands go up. And they stay there, and they say yeah, and they say that.
That was fantastic. I, for one, I did play sports, in middle school. I cannot play soccer. The ball does not go where it needs to go. So the fact that he made it in the net, on stage, in front of people is just, I can't say that word, fantastic. up next, we have contestant number 10, Jaden Lovell, who will surely light up your night.
VIP. Let's kick it. Collaborate and listen. I sit back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a harpoon daily and nightly.
Will it ever stop?
Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I'll glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle.
Much time went into that one, whether it was them making that or maybe a mother, but good job. The song choices were truly fantastic. I know I said that word a lot, I'm really sorry for it, but like I am a New Kids Block, like New Kids on the Block fan, so that was really nice to hear it, and that's all I have to say. And they did the moves from the music video, which was just 10 out of 10. So, are we ready? Next one? I think they're ready, you can say it. That's you.
The next act will make you only wear pink on Wednesdays. Contestant number 11, Aiden Toomey.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells ring, and jingle bells ring, snowing and blowing, all social fun. Now the jingle hop is coming.
the night away. Jingle bell time is the swell time to go riding in a one-horse sleigh.
So fetch. Yeah, we have another trivia for all of you guys. This is two people. One is technically one of the helpers. One of them is one of the contestants. But which one of the two actually got into a fist fight with each other once? If you get one of them, that... Yeah, actually, yeah. Didn't you think Colin Brown?
Maybe that was a parent of one of those kids.
But that's all going to come back around, and this will potentially be their second and final fight. Up next, we have number 12, Tim Heath, which is sure to knock you out.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the main event. The heavyweight championship of the world! And our defending champion, Ivan Drago! And his challenger, Rocky Balboa!
On, we took a bow and made a stand. Started swaying with the hair.
Championship of the world. Ooh, no, sorry. By total knockout, Rocky Balboa.
We are the champions, my friend. And we'll keep on fighting till the end.
I wonder who won that fight the first time around, but maybe we're better off. Do you know who won? When I actually fought? If you didn't hear, he said Tim got a black eye and Colin cried, so it was a draw. Next up, we have contestant number 14, Chris Omen, or also known as Bob Ross.
Everybody, just relax and enjoy. How's it going, Sandy's Bridgewater?
Sunshine.
Pass that math, please.
I failed it.
What was the score?
50.
But
it's cold outside.
It's okay, I'll get the next one.
Time. I don't know how you're going to pick, and I can't wait to hear what the winner is. But up next, we are going to move on to our formal wear of the evening. All tuxes were donated by the Marians Brothers in Brockton, and they definitely made sure that our contestants looked their best on the stage. So up first, we have contestant number one, Nicholas Caposi, escorted by Natalie West. Nick was born on February 21st, and after high school, Nick is undecided, but is leading towards attending UMass Amherst Eisenberg School of Business. He is an expert baker, an avid movie watcher, and a defending fantasy football champion. A fun fact about Nick is that his brother punched out his first tooth. Nick, why should you be Mr. EBHS?
Why should I be Miss VHS? Because my grandmother says I'm the most handsome on stage. Thank you.
Moving on to contestant number two, we have Aiden Flaherty, escorted by Rachel Rinker. Aiden was born on October 21st. He is going to Wentworth Institute of Technology. He plays basketball, and his hobbies include just winning. Fun fact, Aiden is 6'6" with no shoes on. He has one sister, and his favorite food is cheeseburgers.
Last book Aiden read was If You Give a Mouse a Cookie. Aiden, if you could give your younger self one piece of advice, what would it be?
If I could give myself, my younger self, one piece of advice, I would tell him some winning lottery numbers and a perfect March Madness bracket.
Thank you, Aiden. Up next, we have contestant number 3, Caden Keene, escorted by Lily Cookson. Caden was born on April 28th, and after high school, Caden plans on studying mathematics. Caden can count up to 57 in under 7 minutes. He has 2 older brothers, Dan and Gavin, and 1 older sister, Emily. His favorite food is raw flour. And the last book he read is The Very Hungry Caterpillar. Caden, what is your biggest fear?
In order, my biggest fear, number 1, left-handed people. Number 2, Willem Dafoe. Number 3, goblins.
Thank you, Caden. Up next, we have contestant number 4, Jace Allen, escorted by Kylie Keenan. Jace was born on May 22nd. After high school, Jace plans on getting a degree in history and then pursuing a law degree. Jace plays lacrosse, and his hobbies include hula hooping. Fun fact, Jace can't eat bread. Jace has 2 sisters, Bria and Lexi. His favorite food is buffalo chicken dip, and his favorite color is red-purple. Some of you may call that maroon.
There's a difference.
Jace, where do you see yourself in 10 years?
In 10 years, I see myself on Mars.
Thank you. Up next, we have contestant number 5, Gavin McLeod, escorted by Lilia Fagundes. Gavin was born on October 7th, and after high school, Gavin is attending Mass Maritime Academy. His sports include football and track, and his hobbies are going to the gym. Fun fact, Gavin's favorite song is It's 5 O'Clock Somewhere by Alan Jackson and Jimmy Buffett. He has 1 sister. His favorite food is Raising Cane's. And the last book he read was Astrophysics for People in a Hurry by Neil deGrasse Tyson.
That's true, by the way.
Gavin, what is your ideal date?
My ideal date is somewhere on a beach with my beautiful girlfriend, Lilia, and Chipotle. Guaranteed Chipotle.
Thank you. Thank you, Gavin. Up next, we have contestant number 6, Brennan Shea, escorted by Sarah Sylvia. Brennan was born on November 14th. He is also going to Massachusetts Maritime Academy. Brennan was a captain this year in football, winter track, and spring track. Some of Brennan's hobbies are fishing, survival specialist, and NASCAR driver. Fun fact, Brennan can do a backflip and a double backflip on a trampoline. His favorite food is the family-sized chicken parm from Johnny Mac's. And the last book he read was the Holy Bible.
Great read.
Brennan, if you could have any superpower, what would it be?
My superpower? If I could have any superpower, I would choose flying so I could leave my house 1 minute before school starts.
Thank you. Up next, we have contestant number 7, Colin DeChambeau, escorted by Ava Blandon. Colin was born on November 26th, and he's going to Rensselaer Polytech Institute for Mechanical Engineering. A fun fact about Colin is that he once wrote a love poem in the 3rd grade, but the teacher got a hold of it and made him read it out loud to the girl he wrote it for and apologized because the teacher said she can't use the word love in her class, and everyone else in the room could hear it. And that girl was Ava Blandon. His favorite food is bow tie pasta and meatballs from Johnny Mac's, and his favorite color is navy blue. Colin, if you couldn't win the title of Mr. EBHS, who would you want to win?
If for some reason I couldn't win the title of Mr. EBHS, I would want Sean Thomas to win. You know, he's one of the best guitar players I know. He helped me with my act, and I couldn't ask for a better friend.
Great answer. Thank you. That was so sweet. Up next, we have contestant number 8, Connor Cole, escorted by Ella McCarthy. Connor was born on December 23rd, and he is going to Bridgewater State University. He plays both soccer and baseball. His hobbies are golfing, spending time with friends and family, and driving around. Fun fact, Connor almost lost his finger in a metal sander and metal manufacturing class. His favorite food is the pretzel baconator from Wendy's, and the last book he read was The Kite Runner. Connor, if you could have any superpower, what would it be?
If I could have any superpower in the world, it would be the invisibility so I can leave school.
Thank you. Up next, we have contestant number 9, Leo Donato, escorted by Angela DeCaris. Leo was born on May 18th and is going to the Southern Illinois University. He plays football and participates in spring track. His hobbies include hanging out with his friends and just enjoying life. Fun fact, Rio can spin a basketball on his finger. He has one younger brother, and his favorite food is the Golden Fever Tenders from the 99. And the last book he read was The Diary of a Wimpy Kid. Rio, what is your dream job and why?
My dream job is to be a fake homeless person so people will give me money for free.
Thank you. Up next, we have contestant number 10, Jaden Lovell, escorted by Leah Foley. Jaden was born on September 1st, and he is going to Rhode Island College next year. Jaden plays baseball, and he likes to fish. Fun fact, Jaden has had perfect attendance throughout high school. I don't know if I believe that. He has one sibling, a 14-year-old brother, Brody, who was in his talent tonight. And the last book he read was Hamlet. Jaden, if you could have dinner with someone, dead or alive, who would it be and why?
If I could have dinner with someone dead or alive, it would be Ted Williams, because he's the greatest baseball player ever, and who wouldn't want to have dinner with him?
Thank you. Up next, we have contestant number 11, Aiden Toomey, escorted by Chloe Levine. Aiden was born on August 25th, and after high school, Aiden plans on going to trade school to become an electrician. He plays basketball, track, and soccer. His hobbies include bowling and sports. Fun fact, Aiden won prom king last year. He has two sisters, Caitlin and Caroline, and they are both in college. His favorite food is buffalo chicken dip. The last book he read was The Kite Runner, and his favorite color is blue. Aiden, if you were an animal, what would you be and why?
I would be an elephant because I can be bigger, stronger, and better than everyone else.
Thank you. Up next, we have contestant number 12, Tim Heath, escorted by Riley Richardson. Tim was born on July 19th, and he is also going to Mass Maritime Academy next year. He plays football, track, and soccer. His hobbies include space engineering and powerlifting. Fun fact, Tim can do a handstand push-up, and he has one sister. Tim's favorite food is steak and shrimp, and the last book he read was Timothy from the Holy Bible. Tim, if you had a genie in a bottle and it could only grant you one wish, what would it be?
If I had a genie in a bottle and it could only grant me one wish, it'd be to solve world hunger.
Thank you. Up next, we have contestant number 13, Sean Thomas, escorted by Chloe Bob. Sean was born on October 8th, and he is going to UMass Amherst. He does not play any sports, but he's very heavily involved in the music department. His hobbies include playing guitar, rock climbing, and going through the Wendy's drive-thru. Fun fact, for comfy clothes, Sean chooses jeans and a belt because look good, feel good. He has one sibling, Nicole, who is 28, and his favorite food is the Costco pizza. Sean, who in your life do you look up to the most?
The person in my life I look up to the most is Aiden Flaherty. As a 6'6 hunk of a man, I usually have to crane my neck to talk to him.
Thank you. Next up, we have contestant number 14, Christopher Omen, escorted by Mia Royal. Chris was born on June 30th. After high school, Chris plans to hit up the local 537. Chris plays football and runs in track. His hobbies include bowling and women's BU basketball. Fun fact, Chris is a big BU fan. He has two brothers and a sister, and his favorite food is a bacon, egg, and cheese on a croissant from Mary Lou's. Chris, if you were an ice cream flavor, what would you be and why?
If I could be an ice cream flavor, I'd probably be chocolate, because it's the best kind.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now it is time for the judges' deliberation, and as you know, this is our 20th anniversary, so EBCAM and M. Kerrigan have been amazing enough to create a short video that brings us back through the Mystery VHSs of the past. Also, in your program, there is a QR code, so don't forget to take a minute and vote for your fan favorites.
I'm contestant number 5, Chris Sapiro, and I can be your hero.
Mr. EBHS 2006, contestant number 5, Chris Sapiro.
I'm Jake Ellis, contestant number 11, and it's go time.
This year's Mr. EBHS is Jake Ellis.
Crazy James Adams, I'm contestant number 13, and that's your lucky number, baby.
The first place winner with $200 plus prom tickets. Please give it up for Mr. EBHS 2008, number 13, James Adams.
Hey, I'm Chris Harvey, contestant number 11, and I'm gelling like a felon. Want some melon?
And this year's Mr. EBHS 2009 first prize, $200 plus prom tickets, goes to number 11, Mr. Chris Harvey.
every dog tunnel.
Hi, I'm Bernard Campos. I'm contestant number two. Has anyone seen my other shoe? So you're going. Could care less about the five you're blowing. Thanks, Drew.
The winner, first place,
Mr. EBHS 2010,
is
contestant number two, Bernard Campos.
Look at him. How's the song go? Walking
I
so
never put you in charge of the
nice. That looks like a scarf.
I don't care. There he is.
Get those stakes up higher.
I'm Joe Colvin, contestant number 12, and I'll be your little Christmas song.
Mr. EBHS 2011 is number 12, Joe Colvin.
The winner of Mr. EBHS 2012 is contestant number two, Pat Hatchie.
Eric Hunter, contestant number 5, I'm gonna buzz all your beehives.
Mr. EBHS 2013 is Eric Hunter.
Give it up!
The winner of Mr. EBHS 2014 is contestant number 3, Bryce Avery.
I'm Jared Vargas, contestant number 15. This is Lexi Gay, and she is my queen.
The Mr. EBHS 2016 is Jared Vargas.
I just want to shout out to the neighborhood. You guys are out there watching right now, or you will be watching it eventually. Couldn't have done it with you guys. Uncle Billy. Mom, Dad, love you. What do you want me?
I'm Mike Moore, I'm contestant number 14. I'm better than all these chumps, and that'll be seen.
Because guess what award it is? It is your Mr. EBHS for 2017.
Can you get a drum roll, Lana?
Drum roll, please, guys, please.
This is no joke!
Long may he reign until next year when whoever wins. Michael Moore! My liege, take the clown. Huh? I was told to say, you are now better than your brother! You did it! Do you like to say anything?
You know, I've gone through 18 years of my life, second in my family. This is where I take first. I know you're out there somewhere. You're finally behind me, buddy. You're finally behind me.
I'm Rob Lozier, contestant number 9, and I'm the only one who can make this parrot suit look so fine.
And your winner of Mystery Beaches 2018, Robert Lozier!
Evan Dyer, contestant number 5. I'm going to keep this crowd alive.
The winner of Mr. EBHS is... Evan Dyer!
First off, I'm going to thank my parents, of course, because... They are there for me all the time. Shout out my girlfriend Isabella Dalto. I love you.
Mitch Gary, contestant number 5. I'll make you feel alive.
It's the winner of Mr. EBHS 2021. Mitch Gary! Give it up for Mitch!
I'm Andrew DeChico, contestant number 6, and I'm going to be like Mitch.
Your 2022 Mr. EBHS is Andrew DeChico!
Good job, Andrew, good job.
I'm Jill, contestant number 13. Best for last is the place for me.
And your winner
of Mr. EBHS 2023
is
Giovanni
Pires DePina.
That was awesome. Just nice to reminisce on all the past years. Thank you, Anne, and the whole team who created that video for us. So the votes are in. Some very eager people back here. But hold on one second. Something from the students.
Hi, everyone. As you all probably know, Key Club puts on Mystery VHS every year. And on behalf of myself and the rest of the officers, we just want to thank Ms. Lasley, wherever she is, for all the hard work that she does and puts into the show and everything else that she does. And now, let's see the results. So, up first, we have our winner of the fitness and athletic portion of the show. Our winner is Tim Heath. The winner of the talent portion is Sean Thomas. Our winner of the formal wear is Chris Oman. And our fan favorite, the votes are in, and it is Colin DeChambeau. And now we have our runner-ups and our winners. So first up, we have our second runner-up. Drum roll, please. Aiden Flaherty. For our first runner-up, we have, drum roll, Colin DeChambeau. And for Mystery BHS 2024, we have, drumroll, Brennan Shea! So thank you to everyone for coming out. We hope you enjoyed the show, and fantastic job to all of you guys for putting this on. So thank you.